Welcome back, everybody, here to your coverage of the Dota Pit Season 4 by G2A. I am your host for the English live stream in our last game of the Southeast Asian Day. Signature Trust going up against 1-2-3. In the first game, taking roughly an hour to complete. We've had some long games, we've had some long days, and let's get ourselves into it. Because we're not done yet! There's more to come. There's European matches starting up and probably going until like another 12 hours from now is probably when those matches will end as well. And that'll all begin in about 2.5 hours, or 3.5 hours, sorry, from now. But we'll focus on Signature Trust versus 1-2-3. And of course, the man joining me for the entire series today, waking up early in his time zone, it is Motpax. Welcome back, man.
Ah, good to be back. Yeah, we're into the fourth and final match, at least for us right now, at least for me. So it's been pretty great, you know. We got that Doom Band out this time, so we'll be seeing the Shadow Fiend, and if it's any indication of earlier, it should be quite the performance.
I'm really just sorry. Yamata SF just brings back so many warm memories. I'm hoping he is going to be the man who plays at this game. We're combining up.
Oh no, I was gonna say I was just taking a look and seeing how they've been valuing it lately. Because I know Yamata, like when I think of like his Queen of Pain, it's like one of his big ones all time and everything like that. But not opting for it here, it just really shows like he's actually 0-2 with it this patch. So just Queen of Pain kind of fallen off a bit. Like she was so highly valued, and then 6.5 rolls around, it gets later into the patch, and the Shadow Fiend is just he's the big boss. Everyone else got nerfed a little bit, he's still right up there. So they'll answer back, of course, with the Wind Ranger, pretty nice up against the SF. And moving into kind of the mid-game, you still have to always watch out for that Requiem, though.
Yes, you do. And how do you even watch out for it? When the Bane's got Nightmare as well as Fiend's Grip, he can technically lock two targets right on top of the Requiem position.
Yeah.
And now you've also got a Dazzle block pick by 1-2-3. Trust can't get the combo out. This is when they almost should take a leaf out of... actually, was it Ehome that did it? The Abaddon build.
Yeah, that was Lanem. Was always playing it. Yeah. So good. And when you're looking at the Dazzle plus Shadow Fiend's also an amazing combo. Like, it basically guarantees you're going to get off the Requiem. And so that's something that you always need in all these fights. You're reducing the damage. You're having this massive damage output. And the Rise of Bane, like, I can't believe it took this long to happen. Honestly, like, it's just something that he just started popping up. But when you look at some of these heroes that are so strong right now, like the Shadow Fiend, you can put it right into a Requiem. The IO combinations, it sets up nice, easy relocates. We've known that for a long time. But then with the Tiny, you set up the Avalanche Toss. Even with the Wind Rangers on your team, you set up these easy shackles. It's just crazy how well teams are starting to play with the Nightmare to put in themselves into a favorable position going into basically every single team fight.
Mm-hmm. It's the perfect control guy. That's the reason why he has to be banned out in the first two. Or if you don't, you let it through and you just have to deal with the consequences. Lich pick up now by Trust. We've seen this guy a lot today. Really effective as well today. Like, the ability to split up during the fights is just not being there for most teams. But a lot of that came down to interesting coordination as well.
Yeah, the Rise of Dual Lanes is just so great for Lich, but it also has a lot to do with the whole physical damage meta that we're in right now. You know, Ice Armor is just so good up against a lot of these heroes. It's going to help balance out from the Shadow Fiend and, of course, the Dazzle with the Weave and the presence of the Dark Void. So now, looking for their next hero. I'm sure they'd love, obviously, something like the Slayer, you know, to go with their whole theme, but obviously grabbed up by Signature Trust. So what kind of an offlaner could they look for in this situation?
In this situation for Trust?
For
1-2-3. Yeah, they're both in the same situation. With no Tuskar, they move towards the Earthshaker for 1-2-3. Pretty damn good hero, really. Like, they're not going to do that much to control him. Getting the kills when you have a support Lich is not really going to happen either, and you're probably assuming too is a dual lane on top. You know what game this is? It's... I wasn't gonna say that. I was actually gonna say it's a Rubik game. It's a Rubik game for Trust, where they could actually run like a Rubik and plus one on the top lane. I was thinking they'd have a little bit more damage behind them, but now I'm 10 seconds not so certain about that in the early stages. But he's just so good up against the Bane, takes everything great from the Dazzle, and always has good steals from the Earthshaker.
Reserve time. Bristles having a rough go over this patch. I know he has one of the lowest pub win rates, but even in the competitive scene, he's down there right near the depths in terms of the bottom. Like, we're talking 10th.
Are we talking picks, or are we talking win rate?
We're talking win rate. Well, like, he actually has quite a few picks. He's actually up to 65 picks in total, and he's at 15th place in terms of win rate, like 15th from last. So he's at like 34% win rate.
Okay, yeah, that's not great.
No, not too good. Like, he's sitting down there with like Lion and Storm Spirit and Naga Siren, so right in the depths.
Okay, so you. Okay, so you take out the Wyvern. That makes sense. Huskar being the final bet out.
Good call.
I'd actually look towards the Anti-Mage, though. The primary reason for that is, where is your control? Where's your lockdown? Slaughter will have a crush, Windrange will have a shackle, and then you're basically out. Mana Burn is beautiful up against a Bristleback. That's where my mind went, at least. I didn't know what else you'd probably get. If you pick up a good call,
Ember is still in the field. It's not really one of those games where you're like, oh, we need an Ember Spear, but he's not exactly bad against a lineup like this. Of course, he'll have a hard time with the Bristleback, so maybe you're thinking something that has a little bit more burst damage, like a Sven or something like that. Also kind of fits in with your whole armor theme. Kind of depends on the player.
Just trying to think about what's a better option, but it's... Yeah, maybe that is just it. Like, just go for whatever is comfortable for the player. So, PPX.
5 seconds remaining.
Goodbye, Bristle.
Just.
Yeah.
What? Okay. Now, how do you want to lane this? Do you run a Dazzle Axe dual off lane and Earthshaker Bane safe? You're running a melee hero versus a Bristleback willingly.
Maybe with the Bane you can zone him out with the little help from the Dazzle. You have a solo. Oh man, it's gonna be like Lich. They could go Lich Bristleback off lane though.
Yeah,
that sounds impossible
they can.
To deal with.
And what's Bane gonna do against that? Good frickin' luck. You get the wave pulled back. You have to keep the Bane in the lane. And even then, if Bristleback gets like an early point up in Nasal Goo, you're going to combine a double slow, a dual slow from Bristleback and Lich. The Frost Blast plus the Nasal Goo, stacking up quills as you go. Very easy to find the pickups. And they even get the Rubick pickup, which was still available in the pool. And that'll allow them to have really secure dual lanes. You throw the axe back. The Bane can't get a full Fiend Grip duration off. Urshika's Fissures no longer block. In fact, sometimes they can actually work against you. The Dazzle Shallow Grave is the primary thing they have going for them. But you can stay alive longer, and the Fire means you just get more Quill Sprays on you. Hey. This SF is going to have a lot to do. Yavatar is going to have to carry this game so damn hard. I don't understand the Axe pick. I don't understand it. It seems like they're drafting themselves into a harder position. Running melee, like, the reason why I went to the Anti-Mage is because you can burn off the mana and then the Bristleback loses most of his power. At least the Axe has armor gain. That's an upside. So when he goes for the call, the Slaughter's Amplification won't do as much. If I'm looking at bright sides here. Explain it to me. Why? Why the axe?
The only reason it comes to me would be against the Bristleback, because you can still dunk him. Like, when he starts getting low, it doesn't matter which way he's facing Bristleback. Like, the passive has no effect on Calling Flame.
That is true. But at the same time,
like, thing I can think of.
Like, if he's getting low, you could have something probably a little bit more useful, like a Necrophos.
True, but you'll still get the... if he still gets the back turn to you, then, like, you still have to, like, aim it, whereas the Calling Blade just, it does not matter at all. But yeah, I know what you mean. Like, it's certainly an option. Then again, there's also Glimmer Cape.
Yeah. Let's see. Maybe it's going to be completely obvious to me, but if it's not, then I'm happy to learn something new about an axe going up against a Bristle. Like, in this lane, it will actually be that. It will actually be a Lich and Bristleback. dual together. So Lucullus will take it to the offlane, AABBAA. He'll be going to the safe lane with my pro, and that just leaves Jab in the mid as the Windranger, who has this really stylish hair. To the feather swing hair.
Oh, that is rather stylish.
I'm wondering what CAC 100% means. Because it's a gifted set. So it comes from pink, and the dedication is CAC 100%. What is CAC?
You're asking the wrong guy.
I am. Well, I'm asking Twitch chat now. The bottom room. Looks like Windrange is going to easily pick this one up. Help towards the bottle timing. PPX is holding the top room for now. Only got a Yamate, so nothing unusual at this. At least the rolling out of the lanes. It is going to be a Dazzle Axe dual offlane. I can see this working if they can creep skip. But you're going to try and creep skip. Actually, Lucullus are switching.
Yeah, they're going to switch this immediately.
This is so good. Like, Slaughter will be nowhere near as effective up against a creep skip. Link being pulled back. Jab hasn't leveled up Amping just yet. With the attack into Ling, he's not going to level up Power Shot and go for it. He just waits it out, but you've already got a Bane who's... Okay, he's just moving down to stack now. That's all.
Yeah, they're on top of ice right now.
Yeah, Earthshaker. Body block him up. Crush off cooldown in 1 second time, and he's in range for it. And then the two basic attacks will do the work, and First Blood goes the way of Signature Trust.
I think FaZe should just head top now, and I think he will. Just grab a TP, because this is what you want. Like, this is the lane that you actually do want to achieve. Mm-hmm. But maybe he'll just stay close and just keep zoning him out as long as Lucullus is still living. Like, this is going to push into the tower for a bit, and he'll just come top right away.
So, AABBAA has all the great space in the world after a great start. Middle lane, Yamate decides not to commit any of the raises as Windranger. She at least had a salve flowing in for her, but doesn't have much more to work with. Yamate is crushing this lane. 7-3 up against the 2-1. And this means Max Souls coming in for Yamate, making the most out of this laning phase. But this Axe and Dazzle won't be able to achieve much more. Like, he got 6 CS early on, that's great for the Axe. But with the Lich Dragon, the creep wave back, and Bristleback becoming stronger and stronger, this lane's going to become harder and harder for him. And you still got an offlane Slaughter who's really actually getting poor CS against Ice. And now he even makes a run for the rune, which Ling will just end up denying, so he's not going to get that if he just takes it himself. I really thought Slaughter would get more out of this lane after the early kill on the Earthshaker.
Yeah, he's gone for the 1-1-1 build on the Earthshaker, so something that you usually do see on these more offlaner types, especially when you're up against the another melee core, right? Because you can start stacking points. We might only see the one point into the Fissure and just start putting into points in the Enchant Totem and the Aftershock just to control up against them.
Okay, presumably...
So low.
He's so... Lucullus can't keep the movement up, though, to stay close.
No boots. Would have been a kill.
Don't have it for either of them. But yeah, Lucullus has the money. Wondering what he's waiting for.
He just bought a bottle, actually.
Okay. Both Lucullus as well as Jab going to start running bottles. Nightmare over on the Lich. They got the Dazzle here. They're grouping up for the big burst heal damage. And now it comes in. The Lich... Oh, he actually Frost Blasts the skeleton minion looking for... farm before death. Either way.
Honestly, what can Bane do?
He really can do a lot.
Yeah, like seriously, this hero is so insane right now. I don't know. I think it's just the fact that he has such good mana regen combined with his low cost on the spells, like Brain Sap 70 mana. I mean, Nightmare is a little costly, the 165, but at least it stays that way.
This laning phase shouldn't be going this way, though. Like, it doesn't make sense that this is happening. My pro. You're running both the Lich as well as the Rubick on this top lane. You drag the creep wave back, and normally you'd have to move one of these supports off the top lane, but the Axe has just gotten so big early on that nothing is really stopping him from doing his work. Lucullus can't stand close because he's too fearful of dying. That's why the bottle is meant to try and balance this out.
Oh man.
But AABBAA hasn't added enough pressure onto the Earthshaker that you've had to rotate a support hero down to help with this. They go again on this top lane. It's Lucullus Well, the axe, he's got five. Yeah, so okay. Badly. Now you start seeing the quill stack do its work, but with a shallow grave, axe will stay alive. The attack won't be enough. 343 just has so much regeneration through the stick charges that he survives. And now Bane comes in for the middle lane. The Observer Ward lets him see everything. This is the nighttime, that's why Jad doesn't see this coming. Yamete, he doesn't
ready.
Have Requiem, but with the Brain Sap and two Razors connecting, they're going to find the kill over on the Wind Ranger, and 1-2-3 are in a superior position now.
This top lane is just a complete utter disaster. Like, the Rubick pick is just not going to work in his laning phase. Like, he's someone who relies on being greedy, he needs to be pulling, getting levels up, get some farm going. And you just can't let that happen. Like, even if they tried to do some sort of a pull, obviously PPX will be over there contesting it. You've already had to deal with the creep cutting, and he's just gonna have to try and come to the mid lane, see if they can get anything here, but...
Pick up. Stunning over on Yamete. Jab doesn't really have a moment here, and Yamete, raise number one. Ling with the brain sap, raise number two. And I feel like it's just a broken record playing over and over and over again. Even this bottom lane. Like, if AABBAA comes in too close, Ice just triggers his Mango, throws out the Echo Slam, and he gets the kill on the Slaughter. And you can see him looking for it. Yup!
Toby the Oracle. Pat yourself on the back there, bud.
MyPro will also arrive just to play around with that. MyPro could die. There's another Totem Stomp here with the damage up.
Max Enchant Totem Build is so much fun to watch. I love this thing.
It's so much damage. Then you've just given a double kill to an Earthshaker. He can complete up a Soul Ring and full Tranquil Boots if he wants to, or if he wants to go another route. Yeah, actually, no, he completes up the Tranquils. And the Soul Ring is going to be completed as well, because he's got the Ring of Basilius. So just disassemble it and build into the Soul Ring. And this Earthshaker can start his rotation. He's a level 7 Earthshaker 6 minutes in. Top lane, PPX just instantly gets back. Now, I think you're right. While I did mention the Rubick in the second pick phase, picking him up at this point doesn't really make as much sense. If they had someone that could harass from range and keep the axe off the top lane from the very, very start, this would be a very, very different game right now.
Yeah, they just needed something like, I don't know, even like a Skywrath Mage or something, because I'm sure Wyvern was banned out and everything. So just something that can help zone this guy out. Because
okay,
PPX
Axe.
Might, maybe.
Well, there's his extra armor kicking in.
He's
got 33 armor. Wait, he could have one-charged. He had 13 at the point of death. He wasn't bashed. He didn't get stunned at all. Lekel's heal gets stunned down bottom lane. They try to push the Bristleback down against the Earthshaker. A lot more favorable matchup. But yeah, the Axe giving free gold over to Signature Trust.
Yeah, it's a bit unfortunate. Maybe just forgot he had it.
That's a big kill for the Slaughter, though. Gives him good levels. Lekel's, this will be a big kill as well. He has no Observer Ward to see this coming, so they just instantly go for the Fiend's Grip. And a very simple execution.
Again, just showing Bane. Like, he just makes it so easy to set up whatever direction you'd love on the hero. I mean, you got, 5 seconds now at level 2. Get in place, have a drink, have a nap, take a shower, come on back, and cast your spells and kill the person back. Like, it's just that easy. I don't know how they're going to find something here from Signature Trust.
Well, top lane is one way to do it. They come in front. PPX was up a very long way. The Frost Blast will keep the Axe slow, and if he attacks into Slaughter, he gets slowed up even more, but the Dazzle will arrive, and there's your one shot that's going again with the Shallow Grave. AABBAA, he's up a long way, but Lekel's, he's keeping these cool strays up. They've got to actually take the Nightmare off him. That's how they do it. The Lich will switch it. He's actually the one to get the kill on the Axe. So both Axe and Dazzle go down. Slaughter will barely live in the trees. The Battle Hunger was ticking him down, but it's only a level 1. So not as much damage. As we go down 6-4 on the board. There's still a 4k advantage 8 minutes in. For 1-2-3 until these last fights.
Yeah, if there's any rotation from 1-2-3, that is a total disaster. But maybe they probably just spotted out that Ice is really low on the bottom lane. Doesn't have enough mana to TP. He's just punching creep waves. And Yamete, he's off the map, but... It's an SF. You know he's probably just farming stacks, probably a little bit low. So they pick their moment, and really well executed. Like, it's pretty dangerous right now for Signature Trust.
It's a trap. It's a trap.
Dangerous.
The Nightmare buys time for Fiend Script to come off cooldown. Oh, they could just do that. Ling kills secures with a Brain Sap as Yamate. It's just like walking around going, I thought that was mine. Requiem of Souls goes off. If he got that kill, he would be looking at his full mech now. Also, Ice, it looks like he bypassed. Okay, no, he did actually finish up the Soul Ring now. So his Soul Ring is a trank, and then it will go into the Blink Dagger. Actually, is Blink Dagger even worth it in this game? Like, it's good, but maybe Four Staff might be a better item to go for. Nothing's really going to cancel his Blink. But I'm just thinking, considering how strong he is, something like a Four Staff might be a nice stat item to have. Still gets you repositioning you're searching for. My pro, the Weaver's gonna start. Giving armor to Ling, taking it away from the Rubick, who's now down at -4. As the Bane, well, the Fissure splits up the fight. Ice, he's got that ulti, but the Lich bounce. It's gonna go into the creeps and come straight back out again. The Fiend Script keeps the Slaughter at bay as the Shallow Grave gave Ling that extra protection. The Lich is still there to finish the job. So ends up being a 1-for-1 trade-off at the moment. 3-4-3, heal in 1 second. 1 second too long. The Shackle flies in from Jab. Trying to buy a little bit of space, but not when the Axe gets the Culling Blade. Buys them more time as well as speed to move over and chase after Jab for the secondary dunk for PPX. Now here's Blink Dagger is almost done in a 3-for-2 trade. Ends up being the fight in top. As my pro just bail the hell out of there.
Yeah, the big boys showed up. Yamate and PPX. And that's just... just go time. So they'll take down this tower. Ice again moving towards what could be. I can see that totally, like the Force Staff, something like that. Definitely a viable option. They're gonna have the Blink Dagger on the Axe.
My pro's dead.
The double Blink is so satisfying. Oh yeah.
He came in to pick up Arcane Boots, buys a TP scroll, but he's gonna have to juke this up so hard right now. Running around with no mana. Stick charges won't help him. Yamate. Way too much damage with the razors. So a very dead Rubick. At least he spent his money before death. But you're looking at a 6.6k net worth Yamate SF. 11 and a half minutes into this game. His major problem right now is having enough mana. Always the problem of SFs who build mech.
And there's actually... there's arcanes for Ling.
Dire structures are fortified.
But we'll see. He's so rich. 1500 already.
Is that Wind Ranger actually just getting a casual Ogre Club? Or is this meant to be point booster later on and go into the Ags? Like, is he considering BKB as a good option?
It's possible. Usually, when you're going the Ags, well, obviously, usually you get the point booster first. But I think a lot of people will get the Oracle first as well, just if you have to buy it out because you're going to die, I'm not sure.
Blink, call, win run, going to be completely evaded as Yamate winds up the ulti with a follow-up raise. This time he does claim the kill. And with the creep wave already here, they can look for more. Actually, they do. Ling got the Fiend's Grip over on the Lich. Raise number one, Brain Sap, and PPX. Too late. Too late for the dunk.
Style points.
It's fine. He saves the mana and then Ling TPs up to the top lane to stop the push. And that Glimmer Cape is almost done as well for the Bane.
Glimmer Cape, double Blink's gonna be up now with Ice as well. They're gonna have attacking from every single angle here. And it's gonna be, you know, my pro, he is up to the Arcane Boots. Looks like he's probably gonna try and grab an Urn, just trying to tank up a little bit as the Onslaught is about to be coming onto the Dire's doorsteps.
They're running after Lakels. No one showed underneath the Observer Ward in the bottom lane, so Lakels feels very, very safe. But now with the Axe jumping that happened.
I think the creep had just died, right? So he didn't have the full vision. I think that's what it was. We'll say that's what it was.
Well, he blinked in and then called like half a second after, so we got the vision after he blinked in. But yeah, you could give him that excuse. Either way, 1-2-3 now. Staring down the bottom lane. My pro's there. He can easily defend this. With a level 3 Fade Bolt, it's quite simple to defend the lane. Just drag the creep wave back every time.
Radiance middle tower.
There's Yamate. Okay, maybe this won't be as easy, because Yamate will just beat the tower into submission. So you Fade Bolt down through the wave, drive the creep wave up, but because you got the SF here, it does more than enough damage to ensure the kill on the tier 1. And Signature Trust, they actually had Fortification, and they could have made 1, 2, 3 wait a little bit longer. It's going to come off cooldown anyway once the tower dies, so...
Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Now, A-A-B-B-A-A, as they say. He's really close to that Blink Dagger. He's just up there punching jungle creeps. They need it for these tower defenses, and honestly, even at the tier 1, it sounds like those will just be too risky anyway. It's a little bit further out from the base, so they'll probably be happier to try and defend the tier 2s with it. But they need it soon.
Well, they can try. I'd love to actually stack up some ancients, but these dire sentry wars just keep missing.
What is this? Mech into Shadow Blade. Old school. He's done with this.
What do you mean old school? No mana! That's the problem. You're burning 75 mana for your Shadow Blade. It's 225 for the mech. And then you've got Razor's worth 75 and you're only worth 175. You cannot use everything during a fight. Even if you switch to Intel Treads, you cannot burn everything. However, you can at least burn the life of the Bristleback. Wind up. Nope. He didn't have time to go for the full Requiem. The Nightmare, however, buys the time. Looks at his front. There's your Brain Sap. The Razor will do the work. Dazzle's died in the meantime in the mid lane, but you're trading a Bristleback for a Dazzle, and you're getting more and more kills onto the SF. It's almost double the net worth of the Windranger.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. I don't even know. What a strange build. I had to look it up just because, but this is only the eighth time, like, ever. And we're talking ever that Xiaofin has gone for the mech and then been like, I think I'll just grab a Shadow Blade next. And that's like 2,500 Xiaofin games. It's just so strange, but you're right. Like, it's like mana issues, right? Like, you're popping 75 for this, 75 for a raise.
Bane's in
the
trouble.
Mechanism.
A-B-B-A-A, she managed to get himself a bash as well, but the fissure near! Oh! That's huge revise! Well, Blink Dagger is worth it! The follow-up call was there from Max as well. They'll chase after Jab. The Nightmare will allow Yamate to run over. Razors, well, one of them will miss. The other two connect, and Ice will grab himself another kill. And the perfect time for the Akros Slam, doing terrible, terrible damage across Trust lineup. Now brings the score to 17-7. You crack the 10k net worth in under 17 minutes for your SF. And now you'll also take out Roshan. Medallions on 3-4-3, so this will be very, very simple. Even 3 points up in presence of the Dark Lord, this Roshan doesn't stand a chance. But Lich, what are you doing? Is he coming down to try and stop this? The Rubik's here too. The Observer Wards are down for both Radiant as well as Dire. But with the Weave starting up from the Dazzle, they're going to have so much armor that this is just not worth the fight. Ice is ready to go, a Blink to Fissure. After Yamate takes out Roshan, there goes your Fissure. My Pro gets caught. He'll end up stealing Brain Sap, but the Nightmare will take him out of the fight. The Lich holding, it bounces up to PPX, but it will bounce no longer. And the Rubik, well, he doesn't get held in there for long. Not after that crush connects over all lane, but Yamate winds up the ulti. Here's an almost all of Signature Trust with the Razors taking out the Lich with the attack, but no, the Crimson Guard buys him enough protection. Yamate, one more attack. Now he can move over to the Windranger, but he won't find the kill. The Axe gets the dunk. My Pro hiding in the tree line for the moment, but Lakel's it's the primary problem. He's lost so much armor, negative 10 because of the Weave, and PPX, he really wants to finish the job. He can't do it until the Fissure from Ice. It'll actually keep Lakel's in front of the tier 2 tower. Axe, still no dunk, but the Shadow Wave from Dazzle will find the kill. Slaughter retreating himself back to the fountain. The Roshan was taken. The Aegis Immortal is still in Yamatar's possession, and that is going to be the tier 2 tower dropping on bottom lane to boot. Signature Trust forcing the issue, and I'm not quite sure it was really worth the squeeze.
Yeah, I don't know if they thought maybe they'd be low coming out of the Roshan pit, but it is a mech SF and a Dazzle, so you'd think that they would be rather healthy coming out of there. So just a risky fight, maybe, probably not suspecting the vision. Makes a big difference there for that fight for 1-2-3, but they just annihilated them. You gotta wait for that high ground push, but without any Blink Daggers, maybe they're just figuring like a scrappy thing. Like, they've got, of course, the one on the Slardar, but you're not gonna be able to set up an easy Shackle, so maybe they're thinking a Skirmish was their best bet? Don't know.
We actually are running double Crimson Guards in this game. We got one on Lacalus, and now we finished the other one over on PPX.
It's interesting. It's not, I guess he doesn't really want to go for, like, the four staff, knowing that he is the Earthshaker to do a lot of this control. So he can opt for, of course, the Crimson Guard instead, be a little bit more defensive, and just let Mr. Ice handle all the dunking and slamming.
This is almost like turning into raid camp, where you have your damage sitting on the back lines through the SF. The Dazzle is your paladin. The Axe is just the tank of the front lines. The Earthshaker is kind of like that wombo combo nuker that you have in your lineup. And the Bane is the controller. That's kind of everything you need for raid boss. And now Ling, well, yeah, BBA is going to blink himself away. That would have been very easy to go for a Nightmare, but there's no extra vision for the Bane, so he didn't know really what he was up against.
All we really need now is just an actual raid boss on the side of Signature Trust.
Well, the Bristleback is meant to be that. The problem is of going for something like a Crimson Guard is the fact you don't have something like a Shiva's, which would have been able to kite out 1-2-3 a little bit more and give you a mana pool to play with. That just doesn't exist. And he'll need to go that way. He'll need to have extra armor. Especially with the effect of Dazzle. Yamate, Shadow Blade! Hey, BBA! Sorry, Jab walks right on top of it! Hey, BBA was already there, and the fissure from the Earthshake will finish the job. He doesn't need to commit much more. They get the call on Lacalus. He'll trigger the Crimson Guard, but that's a full five-man roster behind him, and there's your dunk. A double kill for PPX. And I don't think we're going to be going for the full duration of an hour this time around, mop packs. This looks to be a lot quicker of a game.
Yeah, everybody's running around with those big red balls.
GG! Like
bubble soccer out on the field, but yeah, this one's over.
That was crushing. That was crushing. But the funny thing is, I'm still sitting there at the drafting stage. I'm like, okay, how is the Axe going to work? He should get no space in the lane. How is the Earthshaker meant to work? He should get no space in the lane. That was the two primary things in my brain as we went through this drafting phase. And both heroes got space in their lane. The Earthshaker was fed a double kill at one point to give Ice all the momentum in the world. The Rubick couldn't zone out the Axe by himself. So when they rotated the Lich up, then the Earthshaker had even more space going up against the Slaughter, who couldn't battle. He'd trigger Sprint and actually be his own worst enemy then. He'd take more damage up against the high totem build of the Earthshaker. This did not go down the way I thought it was going to after the first four picks of Signature Trust. I don't know if your thoughts are the same.
Well, even then, like, you can win the lanes, and it doesn't mean the game's over, but when you've got a Shadow Fiend, I mean, that's why this guy gets banned. Like, he has an easy time in the mid lane, and he just shows up with this kind of ragtag crew of guys who are hanging out the other lanes. He's like, all right, boys, let's go. I got my mech going. He ends up with a Shadow Blade. It's just destructive how much farming you get. I mean, look at it, 648 GPN in 21 minutes. It's insane. I don't know. They just outplayed them, honestly. The lanes weren't that outmatched. I think they did a good job in the rotations and everything in terms of getting a nice little lane there for Ice, but just extremely well played by 1-2-3, looking a lot more solid than the first game.
Yeah, that they are. And with that now, 1-2-3 claimed the win. They'll claim the 3 points to go along with it. And that puts them into a very nice position, almost next to Fnatic. They've played one game less than Fnatic. But that's only the first round. We've got a lot more Southeast Asian games coming up. One more tomorrow. So, of course, when are we actually doing that one? It's Fnatic versus Trust is coming up tomorrow at 14 CET. So a little bit later on in the afternoon. And then we'll have more matches coming up next week. But the European EU qualifier, they'll begin in 3 hours from now. Elements versus Power Rangers and LC going up against TBE. That's what's coming up next, so definitely stay tuned for that one. The stream will drop, it'll come back up again in like 2 hours and a half. And you'll have Capitalist as well as DerkaDota being your casters for that match. And you can check out everything else that we're doing. We're also doing the D2CL Christmas Charity Magic. That'll also be starting up in 3 hours' time. But for all the details for that one, go to joindota.com. And for all the details of the tournament, go to DotaPit.com for all the information of that event there. So thanks for watching, everyone. Again, big thanks to Motpax for joining me. We'll definitely have him for future casts to come. You can follow him at Motpax over on Twitter. And of course, you can follow me right here on Twitch, Toby1, or you can go onto my social networks, which is Toby1Dota, on Twitter and Facebook. So yeah, thanks for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed the show. And we'll see you back here tomorrow, or tonight, later tonight.